Praise the Lord. I welcome you all to this Karunya corporate service. As the word of God recorded in Psalm number 138 verse 6, the Lord is great, he cares for the humble. Our God is great and he cares for the humble. Let's humble ourselves in the presence of the Lord and invoke God's blessing to be upon each one of us throughout the service and speak to us. Father God, we come into thy presence, thanking you for all the blessings that you have given in our life, O Master. You are so great and your mercies endure forever, O Lord. And you are always with us as we come into your presence, O Master. Lord, I commit today's service into thy hand. Let the songs that we are going to sing bring glory to you. Help us to enjoy your presence in each and every of the singing session, O Master. You fill us with your presence, fill us with your anointing, O Master. Let your guidance be upon the entire team who is leading the worship. Lord, as we will be listening to the word, Lord, use this preacher, O Master Lord. Let the word that is spoken from the preacher's mouth penetrate each and every one of our hearts and help us to grow more and more in you, O Master Lord. Lord, we surrender the entire service into thy hand. Take complete control over each and every of them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now let's sing praises to the Lord by joining with the choir.
Hallelujah. Hi friends, I welcome you all into this Karunya live service. Come on, just look at your neighbor and tell them, give me some space, I want to worship the Lord, I want to praise Him. Come on, join with us, let's go. We'll sing greatest day.
The greatest day in history. Death has beaten me, you have rescued me. Sing it out, Jesus is alive.
Sing empty cross.
The empty cross, the empty grave. Life eternally, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
Amen.
He's alive. Wash my sin away. Oh, happy day, happy day. I'll never be the same. No, I won't. Forever I am changed. Thank you, Jesus.
Sing when I stand.
When I stand in that place, free at last, meeting face to face. I am yours, Jesus, you are mine.
Amen. Don't you think that's good news? Sing.
Endless joy, perfect peace. Earthly pain, fine, only we'll see. Celebrate, Jesus is alive.
Come on.
He's alive. And oh, happy day, happy day. You wash my sin away.
Sing it one more time, oh.
And oh, happy day, happy day. You wash my sin away. And oh, happy day, happy day. I'll never be the same. No, I won't. Forever I can change. Hallelujah.
Sing, oh, glorious day.
What a glorious day, what a glorious way.
You have saved.
That you have saved me, and oh, what a glorious way, what a glorious day.
Yeah.
And that you have saved.
Sing, oh, happy day.
And oh, happy day, happy day. Wash my sin away, oh, happy day, happy day. I'll never
see it again.
Oh, happy day, happy day. You wash my sin away, oh, happy day.
Come on, everybody who's in the rooms, come on, clap your hands together and sing this with me. I am freed to run. Sing.
I am freed to run.
And I am freed to dance.
I am freed to dance.
I am free to live for you. Come on.
I am free to live for you.
Yes, I am free. You ready? Yes, I am free. Come on. One, two, three, go. Come on, everybody, put your hands together and just begin to worship the Lord. Yeah, 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 yeah. Whoa, whoa. Come on, sing it out through you. Through you, the blind will see. Through you, the mute will sing. Come on. Through you, the dead will rise. Through you, our hearts will praise. Through you, the darkness flees. Through you, my heart screams, I am free. Yes, I am free. Come on, sing, I'm free. And I am free to run. Sing. I am free to dance.
I am free to dance.
Yes, I am free to live for you. Come on.
I am free to live for you.
Yes, I am free.
I am free.
Yes, I am free. Let's sing that one more time. I am free. Yes, I am free to run. Come on.
I am free to run.
Yes, I am free.
I am free to dance.
Yes, I am free to live for you.
I am free to live for you.
Yes, I am free. Yes, I am free. Sing through you. Through you the kingdom come. Through you the battle's won. Through you I'm not afraid. Through you the price is paid. Through you there's victory. And because of you my soul sings, I am free. Come on, everybody shout it out. I am free. Sing. Yes, I am free to run.
I am free to run.
Yes, I am free to dance. Yes, I am free to live for you.
I am free to live for you.
Yes, I am free.
I am free.
Yes, I am free. Come on, begin to worship the Lord. Yes, I am free to live for you. You ready? Yes, I am free. Come on. Yes, I am free. Sing, I'm free. And I am free to run. Come on, everybody, declare it. And I am free to dance. And I am free. For you.
I am free to live for you.
Yes, I am free. Yes, I am free. Let's sing it one last time. One last time. Yes, I am free to run. Come on.
I am free to
dance. And I am free to live for you.
chance together and bless the Lord in your rooms, in your houses, in your temples. Come on. Yeah, yeah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on, let's all fix our attention on Him. Because no matter where you are, no matter in which place you're in, His presence is there right beside you. So come on, I want you all to get connected to the presence of God. And just begin to speak to Him, come on, in your own words. You can speak to Him in your own languages, come on. Just begin to talk to the Holy Spirit who is right beside you. Who is on the inside of you, who's upon you. Come on, just begin to honor His presence. Lord, we thank you, Jesus. Oh, you are good, Lord. Come on, just begin to worship Him in your own words. Come on, everybody. You know, the books of Psalms, chapter 27 says, I will remain confident in this, that I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Amen. I don't care what is going on around you. I don't know how the situations might look. But the truth of the matter is that you are surrounded by the goodness of God. Amen. The truth of the matter is your Heavenly Father has bestowed everything that is needed for life and godliness on the inside of you. And all we need to do is see that. And all we need to do is just believe that every goodness is running after you. Come on, we are not running after the goodness, but the goodness of God is running after us because we are the beloved sons and the daughters of God. I thank you, Lord Jesus. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. And all my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I could sing of the goodness of God. Let's sing that one more time. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. And all my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I could sing of the goodness of God. Sing, 'cause all my life, and all my life you have been faithful. Lord, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I could sing of the goodness of God. Let's sing that one more time. All my life, all my life you have been faithful. Yes, oh Lord, you have been. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I could sing of the goodness of God. Sing, I love your voice. I love your voice. Oh, you led me to the fire in darkest nights. Oh, I've been close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. Oh, I could live in the goodness of God. Sing all my life. All my life you have been faithful. Yes, Lord. And all my life you have been so, so good.
would sing.
Come on.
Of the goodness of God.
Let's sing that one more time.
Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Yes, Lord, all my life
you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I could sing of the goodness of God.
See, your goodness is running after me.
Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me. Come on.
Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me.
With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything.
Come on.
Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me. Let's sing that one more time. Your goodness.
Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me.
I know. Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me.
With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything.
Come on.
Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me. Sing all my life.
All my life you have been faithful.
Come on, sing it, everybody.
All my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I could sing of the goodness of God.
Sing it just one more time. All my life.
All my life you have been faithful.
We thank you, Lord.
All my life you have been so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I could sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I could sing of the goodness of God. Promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, will see it again. Waymaker, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. See one more time. Waymaker, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. That is who you are. See it again. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Sing, that is who you are. That is who you are. Yes, Lord. That is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are. Oh, that is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are.
See, even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Come on. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop. Come on, even when. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop. Sing, Waymaker. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Sing it again. Waymaker, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Sing, that is who you are. 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 Come on. That is who you are. 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 We love you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. Father God, we just thank you so much, Lord, for this beautiful time of praise and worship that you gave us. Father, we know that as your word says, Lord, you inhabit the praises of your people, Father. So, Father, we know that you are here moving in our midst. You are here turning lives around. You are here turning hearts towards yourself, Father. So, Lord, we just want to speak over everybody who's watching this live video today, Father. Lord, we believe just as we sung, Lord, you are turning lives around. You are turning situations around, oh Lord Jesus, and we believe it, Father. And so, Father, we just want to thank you, and we submit the rest of the sessions into your mighty hands, oh Lord. We thank you, and we bless you, and we give you all the glory and all the honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
The word of God is a lamp unto each and every one of our feet. As we have been filled by the presence of the Lord through the singing and worship, let's now tune our hearts to listen to the word of God from the servant of God.
Hello friends, what a joy to meet you all for this Sunday corporate service. God is good, God is great, and together we are here to celebrate the King who is risen. He's not dead, he's alive. And as we are here celebrating the resurrection day of God, of our Lord Jesus Christ, today we are going to see and meditate on the power of resurrection. This event that happened 2,000 years ago has changed the history of humankind. The greatest event that has impacted the history of humankind is the resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ. Resurrection is the great event that brings so much value to the humanity. So as we are here together and celebrating the power of resurrection, let's look up to God, because our God is a risen Savior. So today I'm going to teach you about the power of resurrection, the importance of resurrection, and what God has achieved in our lives through the resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ. Let's read 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 17. The Word of God says, "And if Christ has not been risen, then our faith is futile, and you are still in your sins. Then those also who have fallen asleep in Christ are also lost." Here there is a beautiful question that Paul the Apostle raises, and he says, if Christ is not risen, then our faith is futile. If Christ is not risen, then we are still trapped in the power of sin. If Christ is not risen, then those who are dead in Christ are lost. But praise the Lord, that is not true, because Jesus Christ is risen. Jesus Christ is alive. He defeated the power of sin and death. And because of that, our faith is not futile or fruitless, but our faith is effective. Our faith is fruitful. Our faith has an end result. So we need to rejoice because Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. That's why we celebrate this Sunday as the Resurrection Sunday, where we remember the wonderful, wonderful power of God demonstrated in raising Jesus Christ from the dead. This is the foundation of our Christian living. This is the foundation of our living in Christ, that Jesus Christ is alive. When Thomas approached the disciples told Thomas, "Hey Thomas, we had the visitation of Christ." And you know, Thomas said, "Hey, I can't believe it, because I remember how brutally Jesus was murdered. I remember how brutally he was killed. He can never come back to life." That was the statement of Thomas. But you know something? Jesus appeared to Thomas. Because first time when Jesus appeared to the disciples, Thomas was not there. But this second time, Jesus appeared. And the moment Thomas saw Jesus, you know, the expression was, "Oh Lord, my God." Thomas came to know that this Christ, this Jesus, who was our leader, is not just a mere human being, but he is God, attested by the power of God in his resurrection. And immediately he acknowledges him as Lord, my God, my owner, my supreme master. It is so important for us to understand that resurrection is the greatest event in the history of mankind. And that brings value to our faith. And that's why those who believe Jesus and those who have gone ahead, those who have entered the heaven, their hope is not lost, because Jesus Christ brings life. So let's see from the scriptures, Romans chapter 10, it says in verse 9, that salvation requires two things. So first point that we saw was that salvation, or the basis of our faith which brings salvation, is dependent on the resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ. Here we see that there are two things important for our salvation, and that is for us to believe that God raised Jesus from the dead. Second, we need to confess with our mouth that Jesus Christ is the Lord. This is the foundation of salvation. When we believe that Jesus Christ is raised from the dead, what happens is we receive the new birth. The beauty of new birth comes into our being because Jesus has defeated the power of sin and sickness and death and the power of darkness. That's why this faith in the resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ is key to our salvation. So when we believe in Jesus Christ and we believe that the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ has raised Jesus from the dead by the power of the Holy Spirit, the moment we believe it and we confess it, we are saved. We are saved. 1 John chapter 3 verse 8 says, Jesus Christ came to destroy the works of the enemy. Why did Jesus come? Jesus came to destroy the works of the enemy, and he achieved that by his resurrection. Many a times we think that Jesus came to die, but his death, his suffering on the cross was a means to the end, and the end was glorification. The end was restoring the kingdom. The end was to bring the lost sons and the daughters into the kingdom of God. And overall, he wanted to restore the Spirit of God to the humanity. So here we see that the resurrection is the key event that tells us that the power of sin is broken. There has never been a human who could defeat sin. Satan has been ruling the humankind with his three deadly weapons: sin, sickness, and death. And you know something? The great good news is Jesus Christ came to this world, which was badly, badly bruised because of this sting of the devil. Because of the sin, because of the darkness, we were all badly bruised and we were hopeless. We did not have any hope, but Jesus Christ came at the right time through the womb of a virgin woman called Mary. And Jesus lived as a human. He preached the good news of the kingdom about the Father. And he was betrayed by his own people. He didn't do any bad. But then he was beaten. He was betrayed. He was crucified. But it did not end. Satan thought that he could bring the end to this man who pretends to be the Son of God by killing him. But he did not know that by killing Jesus, he was actually giving way to the purposes of God. And we see that on the third day, Jesus broke the power of sin. The power, the most powerful sting of the enemy, which is death, he broke it by his resurrection. And the Word of God says he did it all for us because we were lost, because we were in the darkness. And that is the message of resurrection, that you are free. You are free. That's why we read earlier, Paul says, if Christ is not risen, that means we are still under the power of sin. But that's not true, because Christ is risen. That's why the power of sin is broken. I want to tell you, my dear friend, the resurrection of Christ has brought deliverance. The resurrection of Christ has brought deliverance to us. That's what the resurrection message tells us. It is so powerful. We don't have to live in the power of sin or addiction. We don't have to cry under the darkness of the fear of death. We do not have to grieve under the power of sickness or disease, because Jesus is alive. And Jesus has broken the power, the sting of the enemy, that is sin, death, and disease. Jesus has defeated it for us because we couldn't do it. Have you ever seen, a story where a child or somebody has fallen into a deep ditch and is not able to rescue? Recently, even there was a news of somebody falling into a deep pit. And, people were trying to rescue, and finally they had to send somebody down the pit because this child who was trapped inside was not able to bring himself out. And this rescuer went deep inside that pit and he tied himself around that small baby. And what happened? He rescued that baby from that deep pit. Our condition was like that. We were deep inside the pit of the enemy. We were surrounded by the sting of the enemy and we were hopeless. But at the right time, Jesus came and he entered our disorderly mess. and He hugged us on the cross of Calvary and paid the price, and it didn't end there. He rose again. He came out of that pit. He defeated the power of darkness and He came out. And that's why we celebrate today that Jesus is alive. That brings me to my next point, that Christ's resurrection is our resurrection too. It's not just His resurrection alone. It's our resurrection too. That's what we read in the book of Colossians chapter 3, verse 1 and 2. It says that Christ's resurrection is our resurrection. We really need to understand that, my dear friends, that His resurrection is your resurrection. What do I mean by this statement? When Jesus rose again from the dead, as He defeated the power of the enemy, which is sin, disease, sickness, death, and curse, He did it for us. And the Bible says that His resurrection is your resurrection too. We need to believe that, that all that has been holding us captive has been demolished by the power of resurrection. Christ's resurrection is our resurrection. That's why when we believe in the resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ, we become born again. John chapter 1 verse 12 says, those who are born of God, they are not born by the will of the human parents. They are not born by the will of the society, but they are born again by the will of the Father who gives birth, who gives us a new and a fresh start with His Spirit because of the resurrection of His Son, Lord Jesus Christ. That's why we have to embrace this fact that Christ's resurrection is your resurrection and my resurrection. It's our resurrection. So we can turn to all that has been holding us captive under the power of darkness, and we can say, hey, you have no authority over me. Hey, sin, you are defeated. Hey, devil, you are defeated. You cords of death and curse and every kind of trauma that thinks that you have power over me, you are defeated, because Christ's resurrection is my resurrection too. The moment we believe that, we see the power of God flowing through our body, into our mind, into our spirit, and bringing that resurrection power into everything that connects to us. That's why we need to believe that His resurrection is our resurrection too. Isn't that a good news? Isn't that a wonderful news that Jesus died on the cross and it didn't bring an end to the Son of God and the plans of God? Resurrection spoiled the plans of the devil. And the Word of God says His resurrection is our resurrection too. Now let me tell you the most important point that brings the beauty of resurrection into our life is making us the temple of the Holy Spirit. The last point that I want to discuss about the power of resurrection, and the most important point, the most important thing that Jesus accomplished through His resurrection was to bring us back the Holy Spirit. Because the moment Adam sinned, Father had to recall the Spirit back to Himself. Because the Spirit of God couldn't dwell inside the body of sinners. That's what we see in the book, in all the books of Old Testament, that you know, Holy Spirit used to come and then He used to go back because He couldn't find a permanent place to stay. And we need to understand that Holy Spirit is the most important person on this planet Earth, given to us from the Father and the Son, because only Holy Spirit can bring the kingdom of God into us. And the beauty of resurrection is, by the perfect sacrifice of Jesus on the cross of Calvary, through His death and through His resurrection, Jesus made us the temple of the Holy Spirit. That's what Jesus said. I am going back to my Father, and I will tell my Father to give you the promise of the Father. And who is the promise of the Father? The Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God. Isaiah chapter 11 says, He's the spirit of fear of God. He's the spirit of wisdom, spirit of knowledge, spirit of understanding, spirit of might. That is the spirit of counsel, and He's the spirit of God. And the word of God says, God doesn't dwell in the buildings which are created by human hands, but He always desired to live among His people. But because of sin, He couldn't dwell inside His people. But praise the Lord, Jesus defeated the power of death. He defeated the power of sin, and He rose again. And because of His resurrection, Holy Spirit could come and dwell inside us. That is the greatest, greatest gift that is given to us because of the resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ. Because of the resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ, now Holy Spirit has come back, not to go back, but to dwell with us, to dwell in us, and to make us the dwelling place of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit is the most important person in this planet Earth because He knows, He holds the purposes of God for your life and for my life. That's why it is so important for us to celebrate the resurrection, because Jesus has brought the Holy Spirit back to us. Now we don't have to grope around in the darkness. We don't have to grope around in hopelessness, not knowing where our future is going. But we have the Holy Spirit given to us as a gift. And that is why Jesus came and He defeated the power of darkness so that Holy Spirit can live inside of us. In Romans chapter 8, we read that Holy Spirit is the spirit of adoption. Through the Holy Spirit, the Father adopts us into His family. And through the Holy Spirit, we learn this beautiful truth that God of the heaven and the earth, He is my Father. He is your Father. That's why Father has given us His Holy Spirit. And to bring the Holy Spirit to you, Jesus went to the cross. Jesus died a gruesome death. And not just that, He defeated the death and He rose again so that Holy Spirit can be given to us. Now Holy Spirit is in us. The Holy Spirit is on this earth. And now we have all the access to the mysteries of God's plans that God has for us. That's why we read again in the book of Romans chapter 8 that we do not know what to pray, but the Spirit of God who knows the heart of God, He searches the deep things and He reveals it to us. So we see that Holy Spirit is given to reveal us, to us, the truth of the Father's heart. Only Holy Spirit can lead us into our destiny that is defined and designed for our greatness. That is the beauty of resurrection, that we have become the permanent habitation of God through the Holy Spirit. Now we are not in the visitation culture where Holy Spirit just comes and goes, but we have become the permanent habitation of God through the Holy Spirit. How did this all happen? Because of the perfect sacrifice of Jesus and because of His resurrection. That's why resurrection is such an important event. Because when Jesus was ascending, He said, I want you to wait for the promise of the Father. And in Acts chapter 2, we see that the Holy Spirit came rushing into His people. Because he was waiting from the time Adam had fallen, he was waiting to come back and find his place back in this earth. Because he couldn't come because of Adam's sin. But now because of the obedience of Jesus Christ, he came back and he was so happy to come back. And now Holy Spirit is here. He is now reaching to you through this message. And he's bringing the truth of Christ to us. That's why Jesus said, all that I have to share with you, I can't do it now because you can't take it, but the Holy Spirit will teach you. He will lead you into all the truth. That's the power of the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit holds the kingdom of God. That's what we read in Romans chapter 14, verse 17, that the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. And so we see that Holy Spirit brings the kingdom of God, which is the righteousness, the joy and the peace of God into our lives. And the most important thing, Holy Spirit pours the heart full of love that the Father has for us into our hearts. That's what we read in Romans chapter 5, verse 5, that the love of God is poured into our lives through the Holy Spirit. So we saw that the resurrection of Christ is so important for our lives. It is so important for us to believe that Father has raised Jesus from the dead. And He's alive, He's moving, He has defeated the power of darkness. And the greatest benefit that we have received is the presence of the Holy Spirit. Because only Holy Spirit can make us holy, pure, and restore us to the purposes of God. That was the divine plan of God. Hallelujah. What an amazing, amazing truth we heard today. That Jesus, our Lord, is alive. And He is here among us. He is moving among us. He is healing among us. And He is bringing His resurrection power in us. And it flows through us because of the presence of the Holy Spirit right now. The resurrection of Christ is not a remote event that happened in the nation of Israel. It is connected with all of our lives. It is for the rescue of humanity. It is for the rescue of this universe, for the redemption of this universe from the power of sin. And praise God, the resurrection power is flowing right now. Shall we all pray? And I believe that as we are praying, the resurrection power of Jesus will flow into your life, into your body, into your family through the Holy Spirit, and will bring rejuvenation, refreshing, a fresh start, because Holy Spirit is here. The Holy Ghost is moving among us. Shall we pray? Father God, we thank You so much for giving us Your Son as the ransom for our sin. And as we meditated today, thank You, Jesus, for paying the perfect price. And thank You, Lord, for You defeated the power of sickness, the power of sin, the power of devil. You have defeated the power of death. And now the Holy Spirit lives inside us. So I declare that as we celebrate the Resurrection Sunday, as we celebrate this Easter Sunday, as we celebrate Your power over the enemy, let Your resurrection power anointing flow through this video into My people. Let the bodies be revived. Let the relationships be revived. Let the mind and the emotions be healed by the power, the resurrection power of Lord Jesus Christ. Let the businesses be revived by the resurrection power of Lord Jesus Christ. Thank You, Lord. We celebrate that Your resurrection is our resurrection too. Your resurrection is the resurrection for all our viewers who are watching. Let Your resurrection power bring life in all the dead situation. Be healed, be restored. You are a blessing. We have a Lord who is alive, and His victory is your victory. We give You glory, Abba. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you, and enjoy His resurrection power as a family, and may the Lord's life turn everything around and give you hope and glory. Amen. God bless you.
I still remember the moment when Amma told me for the first time that it's time for our family to shift back to India for my brother's education. I was in the total midst of chaos, wondering what next. Dubai had been my home ever since my childhood. Moreover, 2 years of Bachelor's of Technology in Aerospace Engineering in Amity University, Dubai is filled with millions of happy memories for me. My name is Athira, a very proud Karunyan from the Department of Aerospace. I think it's about 2 years back when I first stepped into Karunya as a transfer student from Amity University, Dubai. I decided that the Karunya is the right and the apt choice for my future after a thorough research. I realized that it had always been in the forefront, widely known for its research, teaching, and more significantly, the lab facilities. Moreover, I simply love the beautiful weather out here. For these reasons, it just took me about a week's time to get accustomed to this warm atmosphere. According to me, the faculties are the best part of my department. Their care is no less than what our parents were. They are the epitome of love, care, support, and guidance. Provided that you have a genuine passion for what you want to do, they are ready to go to any extent to help you nurture and grow. In addition, I would also say that the students out here are exposed to the best lab facilities in the country, which are in par with the international standards. I had the privilege to work with a senior scientist in Gas Turbine Research Establishment, GTRE, a division of Defence Research and Development Organisation, Government of India. On completion, they were happy with my performance, and I was really surprised when they themselves put forward the proposal of letting me do my project in their reputed organization. And for that reason, I'm presently doing my bachelor's thesis out there. Trust me, all that I could do in GTRE and in association with various other organizations, including Thaneja Aerospace and Aviation Limited, is all because of the knowledge and the confidence which has been inculcated in me by my faculties in Karunya. In short, the university life out here have took me onto a whole new level of confidence and have refined my personality in every possible manner. The Athira, who walked into Karunya as a young girl, is now going out as an audacious young lady of tomorrow. Thank you.